So, the Freeride project. I think the idea really came about to do this video project in Australia at the beginning of the year with me, Sam and James, and we really put some effort in at the time to get some nice footage and to really make a nice web video. And we rented a helicopter and we got some aerial shots and we spent 2 months out there living together and filming each other and really working together to make it happen.
Beginning of last year, we decided to start the year off with a bang, go to Australia. We'd all been there. Had we all been there before? I don't know.
Yeah,
we'd all been there before, so we knew it had really good conditions, great conditions to film.
Literally picked the boys up from the airport, and the first number we phoned, we just inquired about a house, and half a day later we moved into this insane kind of three-story Victorian townhouse with balconies, treehouse at the back, courtyard, pet fish, barbecues, the lot. It was the dream.
Australia. Just chilling in paradise. So nice and warm.
after our 2 months in Perth were up, we all jumped on our different planes and sort of headed off in different directions.
I went out to Maui for the product shoot, and the boys went to the Ragnarok in Norway.
And I gave Tom a call, and basically we booked some tickets, which was over to Northeast America, down to Dominican for like a month, and then up the West Coast. And that's pretty much where it all kicked off.
So after the Triple S, there was 3 weeks between the Triple S and the Rochamps Throwdown, and me and Aaron decided to go down to the Dominican Republic and stay in a place down there and build a rail and get a bit of practice in and some riding for the Rochamps, so we were ready for it. Went to the wood store, bought all the wood, you know, got the rail build set up back to Aaron's place, and got help from Cameron, and you know, basically got it all together, and then we set it up and set the rail up at the Boca, and basically I tried to hit it once and got absolutely caned, and then I got one solid hit on it and then the wind just dropped. That was the only time I got to hit the rail. So.
Are you alive? That was fucking sketchy.
Yeah, sometimes you make the effort and it's worth it, and other times you make the effort, spend the money and it just doesn't come through. But other than that, we got some pretty solid riding in. I wanna be the
worked out well when we came together for this kind of DVD style project. You know, we got Sam, Tom, James, everyone's just stuck with boots pretty much, and the wake style, free riding side of things is what we wanted to kind of push and go with.
And yeah, we left the Dominican Republic, me and Aaron, travelled up through LA and headed straight for Hood River.
Next stop, Hilton LAX.
Drop the beat on him. Yeah, my name is Chords. You're tuned to the sounds of Super Psy, Flyphonic, Baby Ark, Mr. Noun. You know how we get down, bro. Yeah, chillin'.
When I'm on the grind, somebody's always tapping on my shoulder, and I'm trying to get a peace of mind, but I just can't find the time. My baby's always calling me, crying on the line.
Won't you please come home to me?
Sometimes I wonder how this rapping thing would look like without 100 other crappy things that took my attention and time away from this rhyme I'm trying to say. Trying to conquer the world, but ain't got time today. I'm on a grind today, until when? I don't know. Striving for pursuing my goals, but moving kinda slow. Gotta find the dough, gotta pay the rent. On the grind for show, got a lady friend saying that she loves me and asking later when the album dropping, the video shot, yo, maybe then. Could we find a little time to chill and play again and not fall asleep after sex, but hit the hay again? But working later than Letterman's, the state I'm in. I'm married to this music making, but I hate it when I have to end up wondering where my baby went. But for now, don't tap my shoulder, play that break again.
When I'm on the grind, somebody's always tapping on my shoulder, and I'm trying to get a peace of mind, but I just can't find the time. My baby's always calling me, crying on the line.
Won't you please come home to me?
Now pretty, pretty please, I roam the city streets. Little bit of sticky green clears up my mind when I'm in between a rock and a hard place. They got me speeding like a cop in a car chase. Don't stop and I don't break. See, time flies, so I'm living it up. I always check my stopwatch and I divvy it up. Between the ladies and the studio, I hardly see my family. I'm playing and I'm doing shows, caught up in it gradually. I miss my mother, miss my sisters and brothers, but I gotta keep working, can't listen to others. And I'm caught up right now, but I'll visit this summer. And when the album drops, I'll blow y'all a kiss on the cover. But for now, I'm chilling right here, music filling my ears. Been through it and you knew it, I'ma do it till my mind clears. It ain't a joke, forget the hocus and pocus. When I'm in the booth, I'm totally focused.
When I'm on the grind, somebody's always tapping on my shoulder, and I'm trying to get a peace of mind, but I just can't find the time. My baby's always calling me, crying on the line.
Won't you please come home to me?
Yo, this just ain't how I planned it would work out. I popped the bass in my cans, oh man, I put in work now. But right now it ain't working for me. Got so much weight on my back that it's hurting my knees. I can take it to a certain degree, but not for long. Stop pulling my arm, man, I'm putting down a bomb. I can feel it in sight, it's a classic in the making. Let the feeling compensate for the bread I ain't breaking. I'm sick of gut pains and stress, my head aching. Music made me tick, but it's a tricky situation. Grind it like a 9-to-5, but don't get paid like one. Soon as I can find a time, I'ma raise my son. And my girl is stressing me to get a proper job, so we can get a proper car, get rid of the rusty sob. And how we're back, going on a nice vacation. This album better start breaking.
When I'm on the grind, somebody's always tapping on my shoulder, and I'm trying to get a peace of mind, but I just can't find the time. My baby's always calling me, crying on the line.
Won't you please come home to me?
When I'm on the grind, somebody's always tapping on my shoulder, and I'm trying to get a peace of mind, but I just can't find the time. My baby's always calling me, crying on the line.
Won't you please come home?
Thank you.
So after the Roshan, we headed out to Fuerteventura. The four of us went out to build our own rail and see what we could do, have our own time, you know, play around with it, work out something different to build.
Fuerteventura was a trip to be remembered for sure. I think it, pretty much in the middle of all our time of filming, and we rocked up in Fuerte for the big main trip. We were going to make a rail, we were going to ride it for 2 weeks, get the most amazing footage.
And that's pretty much what we did, really. The boys booked their tickets, I was already out there. It wasn't without its problems, of course.
Test 1, 2.
I don't know where to put my hands. We're out here in Fuerteventura. Tom decided to build that rail.
The rail's been pretty good.
Me and Tom got it started.
Serious started.
Then once it looked pretty much done, Sam booked his flight out conveniently.
Well, the rail. This rail has been an experience. We've had some setbacks. We've had some major setbacks.
Chopped the leg off. Which wasn't a great start.
But I just, at one point, I just given up. I just didn't think it was going to happen after Sam crashed the car.
Yeah, we can see this.
And I lost my phone. And I snapped my lines. And it felt like he didn't want it to happen, but suddenly it all came together.
And then all of a sudden, we bashed a few screws in and took it to the lagoon. And in a day, it was just set up and ready to ride.
Arno and Walter of Book of Shade.
Check out Get Physical Music.
We were always fascinated by electronic music. We're kids of the 80s.
Presento Book of Shade.
after that, we needed, I guess we all needed a rest, and we went our different ways again, with the sort of vague premise that we're going to meet up in the Philippines.
Philippines. We'd already done the Wind or No Wind in 2010, and that was pretty much the trip what stepped all of our rail riding up. And to go to the event in the Philippines was a great way to end the year and the video. And, you know, we took a full English podium for the kite, first, second and third. And then Sam and I got first and second on the cable too.
John Deere. On here's really my time to shine. I'm a fig, come to chat too, but when I rhyme, it's fine.